Today, I'm going to show you exercises you can do to promote improved hand function in those living with Parkinson's disease. Think of these as prevention as well as rehabilitation. People living with Parkinson's disease cannot afford to lose their hand function, or burden of care will substantially increase. I'm Emily Morgan, occupational therapist and certified LSVT-BIG and Parkinson Wellness Recovery Clinician. I want to welcome you all to NeuroVlog, your video resource for getting fast, focused, and fundamental information on neurorehab topics. Parkinson's disease is a progressive nervous system disorder that presents with both motor and non-motor symptoms. It is associated with degeneration of the basal ganglia of the brain and a deficiency of a neurotransmitter called dopamine. Because the disease is progressive, symptoms often worsen the later the stage of the disease they are in. Those living with primary PD have rigidity and stiffness. They move slowly, and they have impaired sequential coordination and fluidity of movement. Specifically in the hands, there is often a tremor, tightness, the appearance of rigidity, and there can even be freezing. You might notice those with PD holding their hands in a flex posture like this. Even small movements like hand and fine motor movements can get too small. When hands don't move well, it makes it hard to do a lot of things. Writing, eating, dressing, holding young grandchildren, and more. The good news is that there are exercises that you can do to change the brain for the better. I'm going to show you wrist and hand exercises designed to counteract these symptoms and improve mobility for greater hand function. These exercises are not meant to be too complex and should be part of their home program and even integrated into daily tasks. Most can be done in almost any position, anywhere, anytime. I will show you some variations to give you options for what suits your patient's presentation best. Okay, it's time to stretch our hand and fingers. So to do so, you're going to have the hands placed together and draw the elbows up so that you have a nice prayer stretch. This prayer stretch helps stretch the flexors of the wrist and the fingers, and it allows for the extensors later on to reactivate. You can also make this dynamic by lacing the fingers together, inversing, and then lifting up the elbows. And you can stretch the shoulders as high as you'd like to. Make it dynamic. It feels awfully nice. You can stretch the arms singly one at a time and hold the stretch for a static count of 10 seconds, 20 seconds, 30 seconds, whatever you would like. Make that dynamic as well. Next, we'll do stretches for the hands in a weight-bearing position. So this is option number two for a wrist and finger flexor stretch. Standing up, you can have the client lean into a high mat table or any kind of table. Keep the fingers nice and spread out. You can add a little something by having the client bend their elbows and straighten their elbows. Or you can have them rock side to side. And that really does a good job to stretch out those carpal bones as well. And then if you'd like to, you can even take the client to the wall and have the client stretch out there with their hands pressed against the wall. Just consider their mobility options, and I'm sure you'll figure out something that'll work for them. Now, we have to activate the hands by focusing on extensor muscle activation. There is an inadequate central drive for muscle activation in across motor symptoms of the body in PD. This means inefficient motor unit recruitment, and it impacts complex automated movement. We need to spend time retraining the hands to move bigger at a more appropriate pace. This is often known as large amplitude training. Now that we've stretched, it's time to reactivate the hand and get those muscles going. So the first one I'll coach you through is open hand spreads, spreading the fingers out nice and big, and then drawing them back in together again. So you can do this in a variety of positions. As I show here, palms up, elbows straight, wrists extended. And you can couple this with a lot of other motions for the arm during reach. Second one that's important is called the flick. So making a fist and then opening the hands nice and big. Close fist, open it nice and big. And this can be a very, very powerful one to utilize when the hands start to get stuck and kind of frozen mid-activity. Tell them to hit the reset button, stretch out those fingers maybe a little bit, and then flick a few times. And it's amazing to see what those hands are able to do again. Next one, forearm flips. Turning the palms up and down, stretching those forearms. And of course, you can incorporate finger spreads at the same time. It's great. Next up, finger taps. So for this one, you'll be tapping the thumb to each finger sequentially. You can focus on the tough ones back and forth over and over again, or you can go one finger at a time moving down the line. So once those exercises are pretty much mastered, you can incorporate it into what we call a flow, if you're familiar with power moves. A flow is basically just linking or sequencing those exercises all together, and you can do it in any sequence you would like. So here's an example. Open, close, flick, palm up, palm down, and tap. I'll do it again a little faster. See what they think. It might be a little challenging at first for them to get the hang of it, but it's okay to mix it up and just work with them grading the challenge. Here is one more helpful tip. You can use auditory cueing to trigger faster initiation and movement speed. Keep in mind, less is more when it comes to your verbal instruction. Provide them with one verbal cue to train large amplitude movement, and stick with that one cue throughout. Depending on your familiarity with some of the PD approaches out there, it could be big or it could be power, or perhaps something else that seems to click. Okay, so here is my final combination that I'll show you for the hands that can be a lot of fun to do with people. It's that game rock, paper, scissors, right? I learned at a course that's a really fun one to do, and you can just add a snap to it. So here it goes, rock, paper, scissors, snap, right? Rock, paper, scissors, snap. Think of all the different hand positions that a person is going through during that one game. So I do it with clients, they have a lot of fun, and I think you'll really like trying that too. What you think, NeuroNation? Now that you know some key exercises for the hand that you can implement for those with Parkinson's disease, please don't leave them out of the picture of treatment sessions, and also get them into their home program. Get creative with how you use them and when you use them. It can be a great priming set of exercises to do before you do occupation-based activities involving the hand. Or you can use them during a walking task, so you are working on dual tasking, two motor combinations at a time. Thanks for watching today. Also, don't forget to subscribe, click on the bell, and turn on notifications so you will never miss a NeuroVlog video. NeuroVlog, fast, focused, fundamental.